Summary and analysis of The Dilemma of a Ghost by Amma Atta Aido. Amma Atta Aido. Amma Atta Aido is a Ghanaian author, poet and playwright. She is also a political activist and has worked as a Minister of Education under the Jerry Rawlings administration. Where is Ghana? Ghana is a country in West Africa. Aido was born into the Fante people of South Central Ghana in 1942 and has emerged as the foremost woman writer in Ghana. Aido's people, the Fante, are a subgroup of the Akan. Akan is a large grouping of people who makes up most of the population of southern Ghana. The Fante are the largest and the most powerful of the Akan groups. They are distinct, even though they share similar cultural practices and speak mutually intelligible dialects of the same language. It is to be noted, the Ghanaian culture sees women as fit mainly for tending the home and bearing children. The perception of this inequality has stoked the fires of Aido's feminism throughout her career. Aido deplores the traditional subjugation of women in Akan culture. She also explores and eliminates multidimensional themes of cultural transformation, feminism, and impact of neocolonialism on the African psyche. In 2000, she founded the Bosom Foundation, a non-governmental organization based in Ghana with a mission to support the development of African women writers and their artistic output. Notable works of Aido. While she was a student in the University of Ghana in Lagan, Aido wrote her first play, The Dilemma of a Ghost. Aido went on to write another play, Anova, in 1970. It is based upon an old Ghanaian legend of slave trade. Coming to her fiction, her first novel, Our Sister Killy Joy, was published in 1977 and remains one of her most popular works. The novel is also named as Reflections from a Black-Eyed Squint. Her second novel, Changes, a Love Story, published in 1991, won the Commonwealth Writers Prize for the best book in Africa. The novel, Changes, is generally perceived as a modern feminist novel. Aido is also an accomplished poet. Her poetry collection, Someone Talking to Sometime, won the Nelson Mandela Prize for Poetry in 1987. She is also the editor of 2006 anthology, African Love Stories. The play The Dilemma of a Ghost was initially staged in 1965 and was published the following year, making Aido the first published African woman dramatist. This play comes under the category of problem play. What is called a problem play? It is a type of drama to deal with controversial social issues in a realistic manner to expose social ills and evils. The mission of this play is to stimulate thought and discussion on the part of the audience. The play, The Dilemma of a Ghost, is divided into 5 acts with a prelude. What is the meaning for the word prelude? Introduction. An action or event serving as an introduction to something more important. The play begins with a prelude, including a poem, introducing the setting and main characters. The action of the play is spread out over a year and takes place in the courtyard of the newest wing of the Odumna clan house. Clan, a group of people with similar characteristics. What does the title of the play signify? The Dilemma of a Ghost. A dilemma is a situation which makes problems, often one in which someone has to make a very difficult choice between things of equal importance. A ghost, literally, we all know, the spirit of a dead person. Here in the drama, it symbolically refers to African culture that haunts the hero of the drama, who is now educated and wants to compromise some of his roots. Let's move on to the characters. The first one is Atto Yazin, a young Ghanaian graduate who recently completed his studies in the United States and returns home with an American bride, Eulalie. Eulalie Yazin, she is the Afro-American graduate. Who is called an Afro-American? Afro-Americans are black people living in the United States whose ancestors came from Africa. Here, Eulalie is aware of her African identity. Though born in America, she still knows that her origin is in Africa. Ezekom, she is Atto's mother and Eulalie's mother-in-law. Monka, she is the sister of Atto Yazan. She is illiterate. As she is not educated, she fails to pronounce some words in the play. She says, Amrika for America. Nana, she is the grandmother of Atto. She is very old in her 80 plus years old. She is talkative, traditionalist and illiterate and likes complaining. Akiare, she is the elder aunt of Atto. Petu is Atto's elder uncle and Akroma is his younger uncle. The first woman and second woman who appear in the play are neighbors of Atto's family. Ida presents the story quite well, balancing the action between the couple Atto and Eulalie with dialogues between two village women who provide a different perspective on events. What happened in the play in the prelude of The Dilemma of a Ghost? In the prelude, we can see Atto, a Ghanaian graduate, returns to Ghana from his studies in North America and brings with him a black American wife, Eulalie. Eulalie is optimistic that life is going to be nice for her on the African land and Atto's people will be her own people. Atto even assures her that even if they don't get children, that won't matter for him, but they will create a paradise in their marriage and having children can be postponed as long as Eulalie wishes. In Act 1, we can find the two women are talking about the arrival of Atto, who is expected to pay the debts of his mother. Nana, the grandmother of Atto, is happy for the return of her grandson from North America. Petu, the elder uncle, asks for the sheep that Ezekam was rearing, and Ezekam reports that she had sold it to get the money to pay the bride price for Atto. I hope all of you know about the bride price practice in African countries that is entirely different from Indian culture. The bride price in Africa is usually an amount of money or property which is paid by a groom and his family to the family of the bride. The bride price in Africa is a sign of the man's commitment to take care of his wife and is seen as a symbolic act and a necessary part of upholding culture rather than a purchase. Here in the play, we can see how Ezekom is getting ready to pay bride price for her son Atto. But contrary to the situation, Atto suddenly informs his family members that he is already married. The news about marriage troubles the family members because it is informed that Eulalie is an Afro-American and her grandparents were taken from Africa to America as slaves. Nana, the grandmother, is more frustrated to learn that Eulalie is an offspring of slaves. Act 2 opens with two women are again talking about how time has progressed and the youths are not as subservient and obedient to tradition as they initially used to be. Eulalie is seen giving a long soliloquy after arriving in Africa. Eulalie acknowledges the changes of her name from Eulalie Rush to Eulalie Yazan. She also expresses her identity and the pride that her mother instilled in her and wishes her mother was alive to see her. Eulalie introduces the idea of starting a family to Atto, but Atto objects that they should stick to their original plan of postponing giving birth to children. In Act 3, Atto dreams of a boy and a girl singing about the ghost, who is in a dilemma of not knowing where to go, whether to Elmina or Cape Coast. One should know about these two places mentioned in the dream of Atto Yazan. The first one is Elmina. It is a fishing port on the south coast of Ghana in West Africa. And Cape Coast is the capital of the central region in southern Ghana. Both these places are known for its role in the transatlantic slave trade. Transatlantic slave trade? Yes, the transportation of slave traders of various enslaved African people, mainly to the America. In the dream, Atto is totally confused. He cannot go to both these places as both are known for suffering place for slaves. Thus, in his dream, the ghost is confused at a junction of not knowing which way to go. It shows the inner trauma of Atto, who does not want to decide whether to keep his African folks or what his African-American wife wants. In the next scene, Atto's mother Ezekom brings snails to prepare the food. When Eulalie sees them, she throws them away. This causes great conflict between Atto and his mother. Ezekom insists that Eulalie has to follow the culture of her husband. Act 3 ends. Ezekom complains about her poorer condition and how money goes just to satisfy Eulalie's needs. Here in Act 4, we can see the two women are again started talking about Atto's family. They mentioned that Ezekom's roof leaks more than ever before because of Eulalie, who spends all the money buying cigarettes, drinking, clothes and machines. They also discuss her state of barrenness, that she has not given birth to children. Atto's relatives come to perform some rituals in order to please the spirits of the dead ancestors for controlling birth. They also inform that they are aware that his wife smokes cigarettes and drinks just like men. So they are going to wash her stomach so that she may conceive. Eulalie seems to be furious in Act 5 and insults the relatives of Atto. She complains that Atto's relatives force their wills on her, including when she should have children. She insults them that they only understand their own savage customs and standards because they are more savage than dinosaurs. Atto loses his temper and slaps her and leaves the house. At midnight, Atto is seriously looking for Eulalie, who is missing and cannot be found. Ezekom blames Atto for not teaching his wife about his culture. Eulalie suddenly appears and she looks very weak and unhappy. Atto now remains confused and bewildered. At last, Atto is reminded of the dream again. An echo from his own mind brings the voices of the children. Shall I go to Cape Coast or shall I go to Elmina? With this, the play ends. What do you understand from the play? It is very clear that Atto is in a dilemma whether to take side with his people or with his wife. Symbolically, the ghost refers to African culture that haunts Atto himself, who is now educated and wants to compromise some of his roots. It is to be noted, since Atto has been exposed to both cultures of educated people and of his own folks, he is now in a dilemma how to balance the two cultural extremes. Thank you.